Hello and welcome to programming in C++ series. In this video, we're going to start off with Chapter 9, which does structs exercises. Before we get started, go ahead and smash the like button, and you can leave a comment. Also, make sure you're subscribed to the channel. When you're subscribed to the channel, you get notified when new videos are posted, and it helps you easily navigate through YouTube. If you don't have a YouTube login yet, please take a minute. That's all it takes to go ahead and create one. Also, it is absolutely free. Alright, that way once you do create a login, you can like, comment, and subscribe to channels, and it helps you navigate throughout YouTube easily as well. So let's go on to our first exercise in this video, which is going to be programming in C++, programming exercise 9-1. Here we're going to assume a definition of exercise 2, which defines a struct computer, write a program that declares a variable of type computer type, prompt user to input data about a computer, and outputs the computer's data. So example input and output is shown below. So you're going to do MC PC 1000 Intel GFX. So that's going to be output. So we'll use these when we run the program. All that information. So here's the instructions for exercise 2. Define a struct computer type to store the following data about a computer manufacturer string and model type string, processor type string, it in gigabytes, hard drive size, integer in gigabytes, year when the computer was manufactured in integer, and the price and double. So for task one and this one, we will need a program to produce the correct output. So, all right, so we see we have some information for us, but for this program, we're going to need to add some include statements. So let's do that. Let's go first with this string, and then we'll do our IO manip. So before we dive in, let's take a quick break and check this out. All right, so we're back. So let's look at we got our three include statements, IOStream, string, and IOManip. Now let's go down and look at our first struct. And here you have struct computer type, and it gives you all the information string, the integers, and the doubles for the variables. And notice here we have our semicolon at the end of the struct. So anytime we write a struct, after we do our brackets, we put a semicolon after it to identify it as a struct. So let's go to our main and we'll get this started. So we don't have to do anything else after our include statements up top. We'll go straight to our main, do some cosmetics, and create a little room to work. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to call this struct. Computer type, and we'll do computer. Alright, and so there it's called. So now we can go into set our precision. And we're going to set it to 2. Next, we'll see out again. This time, we'll do enter the name of the manufacturer. Then we'll use our get line and CIN for 1. And computer dot manufacturer. semicolon with that. And let's see. String. Alright, so let's do our cout. Inline. Let's reuse this. Use it more than once. That'll be familiar. So next, we'll do enter the model of the computer. This time, this will be computer model type. Alright, so we're going to copy and paste this one this time, since we made a mistake with the colon. So we'll keep correcting that. Alright, next, let's go down to processor type. Same variables on the get line, processor type. There we go. Go down and processor type. So next we got, let's see. Size, enter the size and RAM. Enter the size of RAM. And then we'll need to do and GB gigabytes. And then we got computer.RAM. This one would not work, so we're going to use this. We can't use getline for that, but we can use CIN. We'll use that, and we'll remove these parentheses. So since that one, all right. So let's copy and paste this one and reuse it. Similar. So next, after RAM, enter the size of the hard drive. And it'll also be in gigabytes. So here we'll do computer.hard drive size. Built. Built. Okay, we'll go. Year built. Let's go enter the price. And then computer.price. Then we'll go cout. And we'll do manufacturer. processor. Processor type. Let's add line. Out. RAM. Computer RAM. And we'll go see the hard drive size. Computer. Hard drive size. See out price and we'll add a dollar sign for that. Just to have one of the instructions. And let's go to computer dot price. Fine. Okay, let's go ahead and bring up our return 0. Looks like that's all we need. So let's take a better look at this, make sure we got everything spelt right. Year the computer was built. Let's do the year the computer was built and inside the hard drive. Alright, so we're going to go through and we're going to put this information in and ask these questions. Run it. Okay, so we got MC, MC, PC. We got 1000. And we got Intel GFX. And we got our printout, and it looks exactly the same. All right, so let's go down to our grade, calculate that, and I'll show you the code that we got. All right, so here's line 1 through 18. Notice we've added our two include statements. You can pause as you need as we're going to scroll down. There's line 19 to 36. Pause if you need to, scrolling down, 37 through 53, go ahead and pause if you need to, we're continuing, and then there's the end of our code. You see we got our green check mark, and we got 100%. Alright, so we'll do it one more time, we'll slow roll through it, make sure you pause or rewind as you need to capture the code if you're missing something. So that was exercise 9-1. So we're going to go on to the next exercise right after this. Programming in C++ program exercise 9-2. Here we're going to write a program that reads student names followed by their test scores. The program should output each student name followed by the test scores and the relevant grade. It should also find and print the highest test score and the name of the student having the highest test score. Student's data should be stored in a struct variable of type student type, which has four components: student F name and student L name, which first name, last name, of type string, test score of type integer, test score is between 0 and 100, and grade of type char. Suppose that the class has 20 students. Use an array of 20 components of type student type. Your program must contain at least the following functions. Function to read the student's data into the array, a function to assign the relevant grade to each student, a function to find the highest test score, a function to print the name of the student having the highest test score. Your program should output each student's name in this form: last name followed by a comma, followed by a space, followed by the first name. The name must be left justified. Moreover, other than declaring the variables and opening the input and output files, the function main should only be a collection of function calls. Your program should accept no input and save the output to chapter 9 ex20 out.txt, or as 20 ut.txt. It says to out.txt. We'll see. That looks like a capital O. All right, so task 01, correct program, output is produced. So let's go to our code and let's get started. So the first thing I see up here with our include statements is we'll need more. And let's start with include string. Then let's go with the F string. We are using data from files. And get old iomanip. All right, so from there, let's do our constant variable. We'll call it constant integer number, number of students. And remember that equals 20. Let's write our struct, call it student type, and then let's do our brackets, and let's do string. First one was student F name, or first name, and another string, we called it student L name, or last name. To integer test score and do a char for grade. Alright, and remember on our struct we need our semicolon after the last bracket, so we put that there. Now let's go with our functions, void, we'll do get data. IF stream and ampersand in file. Next, we're going to use student type and then we'll call it S list, student list. And we'll use the array box and then let's go integer list size. Sufficient for the first function. Next, we got void calculate grade. go student type. S list, and then let's do constant for this one. COLST constant student type S list. Side we'll use comma, and we'll do integer list size. Two more. Let's do the integer function. Call it high score. And let's make this OF string. Ampersand up file. Now let's use our constant again. Your type and S list, and yeah, we have to use the array bracket for that. Let's go to our next line. Oops, comma. We're still adding to this function. Let's do student type underscore constant student type. Choose constant student type list. We don't need off stream for that. Let's do this. Student type S list, and then let size again. That's all we need for this. Use all the other ones in the next one, which we'll call void print results. Then we'll use all those in this one. So we got off stream ampersand out file constant student type. Here, go out to our next one. Brackets. All right, so that would just do integer list size. All right, so there we have our struct. So we did our include statements. Constant variable, our struct, which is called student type, and we left our, make sure we put our semicolon at the end of the bracket. Then we added our four functions, get data, calculate grade, high score, and print result. So now let's go to our main and get that set up. Let's do a little cosmetics and create a little room to work. And let's scroll down. So for our main first, I'm just going to do ifstream end data. Put our data together. Now for ifstream out data, then we'll add student. Student lists, and then we'll use our constant variable number of students, all caps. So let's see semicolon there. Now let's go to main data dot open. And let's open our file, chapter 9 underscore ex2 data dot text. File quotes again. And just verify that spell right, or you will get your statement that we're about to do next. Alright, so that looks good. Let's do quick if and endeavor. If it's not found, if you can't get it, if it's not there, then we're going to bracket cout. Input file does not exist. And then we'll do program terminates. So then we'll do inline, semicolon, and then that's all we need for that if statement. So let's take a quick break and we'll be right back after this. Alright, so one last thing for this one, of course we gotta return one as always. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy and paste this. Use it again with slight changes. So paste that there. This time we're going to say out data. And our data file is going to be ex2 out for capital O. Make sure you don't put zero. Out.text. And then this is going to be out data. And then this time we're going to put cannot open file, or cannot open the output file. And then program terminates. Inline, return one again. And then we've got that completed. Let's go down to get data. Function and data. Then we'll do student lists. And number of students, our constant variable. All caps, of course. And let's semicolon that. Next, let's look at our calculate grade function. And we'll use this one, we'll use student list and number of students. Alright. And we'll do print result. And we'll need out data, student list. So we got return 0 right there. So alright, so we got our main, looks like it's complete. Let's go back up, make sure everything looks good. Okay. Alright, so let's go with our first function. And we'll go ahead and start with the, let's see. Get data. Let's go ahead and do get data. let's check our variables, stream ampersand, info, student type list, our student type S list, and we got our array box and an integer called list size. That's all we need. So let's go to our brackets. And we'll use a for, okay, int I equals 0. Or 0 is less than list size. Here we're going to do info, and we're going to go S list brackets. Let's put the I in there, the array, and then dot student first name. Then we're going to use S list. Bracket with I again, and then student panel name. Bracket, we just need I in the bracket. Right, and then let's go down. Now let's go with S list I dot test score. And we'll use semicolon there. Alright, so that's all we need for that function. Let's go ahead and pull our next one. This will do, let's do the calculate grade. Same, let's go for int I equals 0 less than list size, and then I less than list size, I less than list size, and I plus plus. Let's go with the brackets this time. Brackets. So let's do a switch, and let's go S list array. Let's put the I in there, and then dot test scores, the score divided by 10, and that should do for the switch. So let's do our bracket. And then let's go over and do our case 10, and then case 9, so we're doing grades, so we got S list I dot grade, and this will equal A, and we'll semicolon that. Break. All right, so what's going on with S list I? S list I dot grade. Break. All right, so let's go to our case 8. We'll troubleshoot that. List thing, and this one will be dot grade. I'll give me dot grade equals. So that's why it's not finished. Go ahead and do this, finish this out. Control C, Control V, and we'll make this 7. We'll make this C. Make this 6. And we'll make this D. Same thing, these will be copy that 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Let's do that 4, 3, oops, 2, 1, and 0. And then let's go S list. Float these errors. We said to be a modified L value, constant type S list. Exactly what it is. Alright, so let's look at that again. So that's. So we calculate grade, we don't need the constant value. We just need stated type. So that should clear up that. And it does. And let's also check for our student type S list, calculate grade. So that was not constant value. There we go. Alright, so we got those cleared up. Let's go to our next function. And we'll go with. Let's go with, of course, well, let's go high scores. Could mix it up, but we want to keep it. Alright. Here we go. Let's do our brackets. So this time we're using constant variable student type. And then S-list, array bracket, integer, list size. That looks good. So let's go. First, with integer, we need our high score, and then this will equal S list with a 0, and then dot test score. And let's do our 4. Get I equals 0. Size, and then I plus plus. If each high score of each score is less than S list, we use our I again. Ready? And test score. if, so let's go down again. This time each score equal S list. And of course I dot test score. And then semicolon. And then of course we need to return high score or each score. And then that's our function. So let's take a quick break and we'll be right back to complete this exercise. All right, so let's go on to our next function, or our last one for this code is going to be, see, the print result function. So let's get that. Let's bring that down. All right, so an off-stream, left stream, that is, ampersand out file, constant student type s-list, and then list size. So let's do our brackets. And let's go integer, call it max score, and we'll equal highest score. S list and list size. So semicolon there. We use our integer I. We'll declare our integer I. Now let's go out file and we'll set width. Student name, let's just give a name, and let's just make these on the same line. Let's go set width 10. Let's call this one. Because we got an out file. And we'll go left. So we're going to left justify it. So the instructions, so we'll use left. And set width, just tell it 25. List I dot student name plus plus class list I dot student f name. Space between those quotes and S list I dot grade. Test scores. Highest test score. Students having the highest test score. That don't need anything space for that one. Let's go. Alright, so let's do another four. So I equals 0. Scores equals max score, and we'll see that test scores and max scores. Test score equals max score, then outfile. Space. So we have a space between this list I dot student f. Sorry, in front of the word, but let's do this line. Alright, that's it for that function. Scroll up, check for obvious errors. Alright, so we checked that already up there. So we don't have any obvious mistakes, so let's go ahead and run this. Doesn't need any input, should automatically output information from Tested it, did exactly nothing. So let's see. Okay, before we do that, let's go. Alright, so we'll calculate it and see what it got. I thought it said no input is required, but I think it's no. What it said about output. Let's see. So the output should be saved to the file. And we did that. I guess we can bring up the file and look at it. It's all right, so yeah, we did get green check and 100% for the grade. So let's show you the code. Everything is correct. So when you run it, you don't expect anything, but like I said, you did get 100%. So that's line 1 through 18. And remember to pause it as you need to, as we scroll down. Got line 19. Through line 36. Same thing, go ahead and pause it if you need more time. And line 38, as 37 is empty, through line 54. Scroll it down. 55 through 72. Scroll it down. 73 through 88. You pause it if you need to, scroll it down, and line 90 to line 107, scroll it down, 108 to line 123, and I'm going to scroll over so you can see line 113 and line 122. Let's go ahead and finish these. That's it. And we'll scroll through one more time. Remember to pause or rewind as needed. Alright, so that's it for the exercise 9-2. Move on to our next exercise right after this. Alright, programming in C++, programming exercise 9-3. And here we're going to define a struct menu item type with two components. So, menu item of type string and menu price of type double. And then our task 01 is going to be menu type item is defined. So this looks like this should be a short one. So let's go ahead and do it and see what's up. Alright, so no include statements, nothing else needed. Just a struct. So we'll do that. I don't know why. So we'll do the main, move this out the way. So let's scroll down from here. Let's do our struct, and it said menu item type, that's the name of our struct, and let's do our brackets, and then last one, we'll do that at the end. So first one, it said string, and call it menu item, semicolon, and double, call it menu price. So let's go with our semicolon here. Don't forget that. And it looks like that's all they're asking for. And it's a task, so we can try to run it. I don't expect anything out of that. I guess they want to make sure that we know how to do that. And let's calculate it. Make sure that's all they ask. Seems like pretty simple request, but it is. So make sure we know how to write a struct. Calculate. And this is great, surprisingly. This gives the student a break from the long exercises, but I'll show you the code what it calculates so you can check it out. We'll just see what it's done. See anything that's missing. And there you go, it's just green check at 100. So all we did was struct menu type, got our brackets. First string is called menu item. We go semicolon, and then the next variable in that is going to be double called menu price. And don't forget to put your semicolon after your second bracket. Alright, so we're going to wrap up this video. That's all for that chapter. What's that? Exercise 9-3. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and make sure you're subscribed to the channel. And once again, like I said, if you need to create a YouTube login or you lost your password, cover it. But it's always good to interact with other YouTubers, and it makes it easier when you subscribe to the channels that you'd like to navigate throughout YouTube. So once again, thanks for joining. We'll see you on the next one as we work to close out Chapter 9 real soon.